welcome to Treasury Notes, a show dedicated to the latest news and information from the office of West Virginia State Treasurer John Perdue. I'm your host, Gina Joines. Well, the holiday season is here. Parties, decorating, shopping, wrapping, cooking, it can all be a bit overwhelming. But finding the perfect gift for your children, grandchildren, even your nieces and nephews doesn't have to be difficult. Coming up later in the show, we'll talk to David Garcia with The Hartford about giving the gift of education through a Smart 529 college savings plan. Plus, we'll see how West Virginia students are learning about life after college and the safety of their school. But first, let's talk about money, not just how to save it, but how to get back money you may have lost. State Treasurer John Perdue's office is leading the nation in returning money to its rightful owners through the state's unclaimed property division. The state currently holds approximately 860,000 unclaimed property accounts worth around $162 million. Last year alone, Treasurer Perdue returned nearly $14 million in unclaimed property to people around the state of West Virginia. Treasurer Perdue recently presented unclaimed property checks totaling more than $10,000. The recipients were a Morgantown businessman and a prominent West Virginia business. Kim Ward has more.
We were able to find a little money for them, $2,495 to the Ogilvy Park, and we'd like to present you with that today.
Ogilvy Park in Wheeling is just one of many West Virginia businesses that have received unclaimed property checks from State Treasurer John Perdue. In this case, most of the nearly $2,500 returned to Ogilvy Park came from a stale-dated check from the Division of Natural Resources. Stale-dated check is one that is issued but never cashed. Another recent check presentation took place in Morgantown, where a local businessman was reunited with nearly $9,000 in unclaimed property.
We would like to return to you almost $9,000, $8,955.18. Let's give it a round of applause.
Scott Huggins was surprised to find out that he had unclaimed property from unredeemed stock certificates. Huggins and his wife discovered their unclaimed property when they searched a national database.
Billions of unclaimed property is returned to recipients all over this country because of the cooperation we do with all the other states in the country in linking up all of the unclaimed property in the United States.
Searching for unclaimed property is easy. All you have to do is log on to wvtreasury.com. It's free to check, and you never know when you or a family member may have missing money waiting for you. And if you've ever lived in a state other than West Virginia, Treasurer Perdue encourages you to check for unclaimed property there, too.
You may have money in another state, and you can still claim that money right here in West Virginia.
Again, you can do a free search for unclaimed property at our website, wvtreasury.com, or you can call our Unclaimed Property Division at 1-800-642-8687. The state treasurer's office doesn't just return money to rightful owners. Treasurer Perdue is also dedicated to teaching the people of West Virginia how to be smart with their money. Treasurer Perdue's office hosts a popular conference series called Women and Money. Since 2002, these conferences have been held across the state. The 28th Women and Money Conference was recently held at Ogilvy Park in Wheeling. Here's Kim Ward with more.
We want to make a difference for you and your lives, and we hope we can.
State Treasurer John Perdue's West Virginia Money Conferences offer one-stop shopping for a variety of financial topics. At a November conference in Wheeling, veteran financial expert and keynote speaker Dee Lee entertained the crowd while teaching important financial and life lessons.
So a comfortable retirement for 30 years is going to cost you...
Thousands of people have attended Women and Money Conferences over the years. For many, the lesson they learn is as simple as recognizing their weaknesses.
I've got a very active life, and trying to get everything organized in my life, I think that's what I need to work on.
Dee Lee's presentation covers many financial matters, from creating a household budget, developing an investment plan, saving for retirement, and assessing your current financial situation during any stage of life.
Your house. Believe it or not, it's a use asset, even though you live in it. Why? Because unless you sell it, or you do a reverse mortgage, you're not pulling money out of it.
This is Nancy Rader's third time attending a Women in Money conference, but she says she learns something new every time she attends.
The contact information to stop credit card offers, and I never knew there was a way to opt out.
While some conference attendees are business professionals, For many in the crowd, the ins and outs of stocks, bonds, and investment portfolios are a foreign concept. But Dee Lee has a way of giving tips and advice that everyone can use and understand.
Dee brings it down to where everybody understands what she's saying, and this has really helped me when I talk to my clients.
Dee spends a lot of time talking about investing, stressing that in this day and time, you have to be informed on the subject.
You're going to have to learn about investing. Savings is not going to be enough.
Dee advises people to take more investment risks when they're young, but as you get older, don't be careless with money you can't afford to lose.
It should not come out of the money you need for every day. It's play money, because you're taking on too much risk at that age.
Dee packs a lot of information into a short period of time, but the learning doesn't stop there. Each conference attendee is given a copy of Dee's book to continue their financial education at home.
It's a great learning experience, and you take away good tools.
Again, be sure to check out our website, wvtreasury.com, for more information on our Women in Money conference series and to look at a schedule of upcoming events for 2012. Well, when it comes to finances and education, the two go hand in hand with Smart 529, West Virginia's official college savings fund. State Treasurer John Perdue believes strongly in the importance of higher education, and the best way to provide higher education is by investing in that future now. Joining me here today to talk more about the Smart 529 program is David Garcia with the Hartford, the company that administers the program. David, thank you so much for being with us here today.
Glad to be here, Gina.
Well, David, let's just start by talking about your role with the state's Smart 529 program. You travel the state educating people about what the Smart 529 program is and how it can benefit them.
Sure. It's a job there. I'm traveling every day. Talking and discussing, you know, what it is and how important education is, but more importantly, that people need to start planning for it. And this program has so many different benefits, we just like to talk about those and make sure that they're familiar with it and they act on it.
And it's all about saving for college. When should parents start thinking about saving for college for their children or higher education? Because it doesn't just have to be college.
I think as soon as they realize the cost is going to be quite extensive down the road. But, you know, some people actually start before their kids are even born, because an individual can actually own a 529 plan and they can change the beneficiary to the child once the child is born. But as soon as they have an opportunity to put something away to start, it's a great time to start.
So what are some of the ways parents and students can start preparing for their college education and start preparing for what it's going to cost them down the road?
Well, you know, the biggest thing is, we never know what they're going to do, but you want to give them an opportunity to do what they want to do and their passion in life. So making sure that a parent says, well, you know, start thinking about where you'd like to go so we can start planning accordingly. And it could be a local college, a community college, it could be a technical school, anything that qualifies the 529 you can take funds out of. But just getting in the framework of budgeting for that. And then the students, the parents need to do things also to encourage them education-wise, take honors classes, to work on different programs to get them ready for the challenge.
You know, we talk about the best time to invest in. The Treasurer Perdue always says the earlier the better, right? You had mentioned that some parents start saving before their child is even born for their college education. But what if you're not one of those parents? What if you've waited? What if your child's 10, 12? What if your child's already a junior or senior in high school? Is it too late to start saving for that education?
Well, there's never enough money. My wife and I can attest to you. We have three children that are, two that are through school, one that's just starting right now. And I don't care what age they are, you can put monies away so that books, it doesn't have to be all of it. It can be books, it can be towards fees or expenses or towards tuition, whatever it is that they're going to have to face, it's better to put something. I have people that say, well, they're going to school next year. Well, you can start putting something now away. It may only be $25 or $50 a month or what you can afford, but down the road it may make a difference to them feeling more comfortable at that time.
So it doesn't have to be a lot. You don't have to invest a lot, especially at first. How much money money does it take to
start
that account?
Yeah. The program in West Virginia allows it very easily to start with a minimum of $50 to start. After that, you can add any amount you want directly to the program. Now, some people do what I have done through my checking account, comes out once a month, and that's as little as $15. So it's a disciplined approach. And that's really what we try to suggest to people. Don't think of it as such a big goal. Think of it as a constant way to put something that you don't think about and it goes and you discipline yourself to do it. Payroll deduction, many places can be doing that right now. Many corporations are picking that up as a voluntary benefit idea. So as soon as you can and as often, and you can add to it birthday money, Christmas money, whatever it might be, to get them started, and then you'll be surprised on how it will grow.
Payroll deduction is a great way to do it because you don't miss it once it's out there.
Anytime you can not see it first, and it's like pay yourself first, it makes a difference down the road that you can do that.
Who can open a Smart 529 account?
Pretty much anybody that is over the age of 18 that wants to create a plan for somebody that doesn't have to be a family member. Many family members do it, like parents do it for their children, aunts and uncles do it for their nieces and nephews. Even friends can do it for if they have a godchild or what have you. It doesn't have to be your own family you do it for. And you can own one yourself if you think about higher education is important in the future, to get a master's, to work on some sort of education. You can start one and you're the owner and you're the beneficiary of it.
And the program's very flexible too. I know if you take out a Smart 529 savings account and then your child decides, you know, I'm not going to use all of it, you have a few options there, don't you?
That's really the magic of the 529, and that you own the account. You name a beneficiary. In this case, maybe it's a child like my son Michael. But if Michael gets some scholarships or he decides he's going to do something else, that money can be transferred as a beneficiary to another family member within my immediate family. It could be back to myself, my wife, my daughter Cassie, my son Joe. It could be somebody with them on my brother's or sister's families. So even my parents. So it has the flexibility to make sure it's used where it's needed.
We talk about the Smart 529 a lot on this program, and you brought up an issue that I always like to touch on. You talk about the fact that students get scholarships. I mean, West Virginia has the Promise Scholarship, mm-hmm. and a lot of times students bank on having that scholarship and they don't think that saving is important. But that's not really true. Tell us why.
Well, because there are so many other expenses besides tuition. The Promise Scholarship just takes care of tuition, and now currently it doesn't take care of all of it. I think it's somewhere in the neighborhood of $47.54 a year currently, and that'll adjust for inflation. But I know with my son at WU this year, I think the tuition is around $5,700. So there's a shortfall there. Plus books, I put out about $600, $700 for books this semester. And there are other fees and expenses, let alone room and board. So there's an ongoing amount of expenses that are encompassing in the actual experience of a college, let alone you go to a trade school that might be accelerated, that is much more expensive, and it might have other needs that are involved.
And again, we should mention that college isn't the only reason to start saving. If you're not going to a traditional college, there are other reasons to have a Smart 529 program.
Well, most definitely. Some people say, well, my son's a gearhead. He really likes to work on cars. Well, maybe he'd like to go to an auto mechanic school, because I don't know the last time you've checked, but when you took your car in to get it fixed, it costs a lot more, sometimes $60, $70, or $90 an hour. So somebody's making money doing that. So it's not a bad profession. There's a high demand for that. Truck drivers, welding, beauticians. There are so many trades out there. HVAC, plumbing, electricians, all those are skills that we need and are going to need more and more, because a lot of that generation that did that is getting older.
Right.
And so having a skill is important, and there are many, many schools throughout West Virginia and throughout the United States that have unique skills, unique trades and such you might want to do.
And Christmas, as I said earlier in the program, is just around the corner. This is such a great gift idea, and I know we're going to have a lot in different mailings, and people may be seeing commercials, because Treasurer Perdue really believes that this is the gift that just keeps on giving.
Think about that. When you can create a legacy of empowerment for your children or your grandchildren, what better gift could you give them? You know, I always tell people when I'm talking, is there's a saying, you can give somebody a fish and feed them for a day, but if you teach them how to fish, you feed them for a lifetime. Why wouldn't you want to empower your children, your grandchildren, to feed themselves? Because that's what you want them to do, to be responsible citizens, to be an adult, and to be able to contribute to society. And having a skill and education will allow them maybe to do that and be very productive.
All right. And there, now is the time to start saving. Now is the time to open up an account, especially if you don't already have one, because there are some great incentives right now to open an account. And we're going to talk about those in just a few minutes. But first, we are going to take a quick break. When we return, we'll talk more with David about the Smart 529 program. Plus, we'll see how some West Virginia businesses are playing a role in helping college, in helping families prepare for those future college costs. That's all coming up. Stay with us.
I look at Smart 529 as one of the cornerstones of the Treasurer's Office. It gives parents and grandparents an opportunity to save for that college education. We work day and night trying to make people aware how important it is for them to save at a very young age for that college education for their children and grandchildren. Education is the future for West Virginia. I believe that's a future for our children, and that's why I've made it one of the cornerstones in the Treasurer's Office.
Welcome back to Treasury Notes. I'm your host, Gina Joynes. We're talking about West Virginia's official college savings plan, the Smart 529. Recently, more than 50 West Virginia investment professionals were named to the 2011 Smart 529 Honor Roll. Treasurer Perdue presented some of the awards to businesses in Morgantown in that area recently, and they were honored for their roles in encouraging families to save for college education. Financial advisors from investment companies and banks were rated on both the number of new accounts opened and the total dollars invested in the Smart 529 program. Now, at the end of August, the Smart 529 College Savings Plan had nearly 113,000 accounts with investments totaling over $1.4 billion. David Garcia is here today to talk more about the Smart 529 program. He joins us once again. And once again, David, we appreciate you being here with us today, talking a little bit about this program and walking us through some of the details of the Smart 529 program. Recently, Treasurer Perdue announced the Smart Savings Match Program with the Smart 529. This is such a great incentive for families who haven't yet started investing in the Smart 529. Tell us why this is such a great opportunity for them.
Well, everybody talks about the expense of college, and everybody would like to have some incentive to start, because it's hard to get started with anything. But if we can create an incentive for families to say, listen, I've been postponing it, but maybe if I qualify, and in this case it's some qualifying factors we'll talk about, then is there some way for the state to help me? And in this case, the grant that we have that allows them to get a grant to match some of their funds, it makes it a great opportunity to kind of see their money grow quickly because of the contribution from the match. So it's exciting for families that have this opportunity.
And let's talk about what makes a family eligible for this program. I know that they do get $500 a year per child, is that correct, if they qualify?
Sure, the way it works is there are some qualifications. We're trying to lift up the people that really need to start and need a hand up a little bit to get going. So we're looking at, in West Virginia, we've had a low number of people that have graduated compared to the United States, so we're trying to help those that maybe are in that gap. Well, some of the things we're trying to do is, if you have a certain income level, adjusted gross income, and that is a kind of a determining factor. Also, how many children you have and the age. So if, as of May the 2nd, if you have a child that's 12 or under, when you start this program, and if your adjusted gross income from last year, they look at last year to make sure you're a West Virginia citizen, is a certain dollar amount or less, then you qualify to get a match, a dollar for dollar match, up to $500 per child. So an example would be if somebody is a family unit, and it could be a single family, or it could just be a unit, a husband and wife. If they have one child, it's $50,000, the adjusted gross income. Two children, it's 60. Three children, it rises to 70. And four or more, it's 80. So some people may qualify for this, and if they do, they apply, they open up an account, they apply for the grant, and then they can be matched dollar for dollar per child up to $500.
That is a great opportunity. How can these matching funds be used?
They are restricted to room, board, tuition, fees, books, required expenses at a college or a trade school. So the normal expenses you would usually use a 529. Now in the matching part, there are some restrictions to make sure that it goes directly to that institution, but it is a very good program that we're starting and we're excited about.
So what do you need to do to qualify for this, or how do you need to apply?
Sure. Once you've opened up a 529, and remember, to open up a 529 as little as $50 to start, then you get a form, and you can go online and get it, and that form, or you can call the numbers that we have for the 529 program. They'll send you a form. You get a copy of your last year's tax return. After you send that in, then they will see if you qualify. About a week later, you get a letter saying that if you've qualified, then that sets it up so that any monies you put in this year, they'll look at in the first quarter of next year, and they will start an identical program that you have that is a match, that will match it dollar for dollar up to that amount of money.
Well, it must make Treasurer Pretty really proud that he's able to offer some different incentives for different families.
I know John's always excited about helping families, and wherever we're out talking together or on his own, he's a big proponent, and that's what makes me proud to be able to work for somebody that really believes education is important and knows that our future in West Virginia, having been born and raised in West Virginia, we really need to have an opportunity for our youth and to grow up and to have the skills that are needed to make us ready for the next century.
Again, if people want to apply for the Smart Savings Match, all they need to do is go online to our website, wvtreasury.com, or they can also go to smart529.com to download the application and see all the qualifications there as well. But Smart Savings Match, it's not the only incentive we have going with the Smart 529. We're also doing a lot with You Promise. Talk a little bit about that.
You Promise is exciting. You Promise is a national firm that has an element that works with certain companies that they have an association with, which we do, that says, listen, we are going to find rebates from companies that you use every day that you might buy products or services from. And we have like an online mall, and so you go and you create a username and a password and you go to their special site, and it's the example, it might be Lowe's, Walmart, whoever it may be that you normally buy things online, and you go to that site, and it, when you hit that particular website, like Walmart, it'll say, we're taking you to Walmart where you get 2% back, or we're taking you to 1-800 Pet Meds where you get 8% back, or 1-800 ink jet printers, and all these companies have these rebates, and many of them have specials that sometimes it's as much as 10%, but it can be anywhere from 1% to 20%. So it's a way to get quite a few dollars by just your normal buying and shopping. And
I know you don't just talk about You Promise. You actually put it to good use, don't you, in your own family?
I think in the last 2 years, I've probably got $200, almost $300 worth of rebates back. And I don't use it as much as I could if I were just to follow and do things accordingly. When I'm going to buy something, check it out online. So they're trying to drive people online, but there's a lot of these major companies that want to do that because it's simpler and easier to do. But it's just a great way for people to look at getting some free money. And you can get your in-laws, your outlaws, whoever you want to get involved to be part of it too. And they can actually funnel those rebates into your child's account. So it's very exciting. And I just tell people to go to the www.youpromise.com, find out more about that program and how they can link it to their 529 plan and really help get that going.
And you said there's a lot of online shopping that you can do, purchase things online, but it's not all just online, right? There are other stores that you can physically go to that also honor You Promise rewards.
Yes, some of them, not as many, but an example, if you went to the restaurant like IHOP, they have a 4% rebate back. I know in this area we have Joseph E. Banks. Well, they give, I think, a 2% rebate. There are places that you can go, like a Kroger or a Shop and Save. Some of those, by just being a part of this program, they get rebates back from normal shopping of grocery stores and things like
that.
And
they have a list on their site of all the retail outlets that honor their
lots
points.
And lots of companies.
But let's talk a little bit about how exactly this works, because you know, when you go to Kroger or you go to some of the shopping centers, you get the card to scan. UPromise doesn't work quite like that. Explain how it works.
Sure. When you go to UPromise, you go in and you create a username and password, then you create a profile. In the profile, you need to put, if you have a Kroger card, you'll put that in a special place. If you use a debit or credit card that you usually buy online or use, you put that in there too, because that's the way they trace it when you use that. If you went to IHOP and you paid with a debit card, then when you use that, that's the way they trace it, and they know to give that rebate back. So it's easy. If you create a profile, and in that profile, it's the way it ties you. And when you go online, that's how they know it's going back to you, because you went to their user site that you had to have that password and username. And that kind of identifies you that you're going to that site, and that's how they bring it back to you.
So we talked about UPromise Smart Savings Match. Again, I just want to emphasize that there are a lot of opportunities for families who are trying to save for college to get involved in the Smart 529 program and find ways to help boost their savings.
Well, and the other thing, you like to save taxes. One thing about the 529, yeah, it's the end of the year. If you're looking for tax breaks, there's a West Virginia state income tax. So that is a way of finding money that you never really thought about if you just had it in a savings account or another source. So that is great, and I tell people the money grows tax deferred, and when it comes out, it's going to be all federal, state tax free if it's used for college or higher education expenses. So, you know, money can make money when you're not paying taxes on it.
And the best part is you don't just have to use your money. This is where you tap into those friends and family and all those people, especially right now around the holidays. This is the time to hit them up for some extra cash into that 529.
Think about it. If you told somebody that, hey, you created a college plan because you really believe in your child and their future, and if they would like to contribute instead of buying the things that go in the corner or break or whatever, Christmas. I'm not saying don't do that, because every kid would hate me for that, but you need to kind of temper that with, I'll put some in that and I'll do some gifts in some other areas. But grandparents especially like to spoil their grandkids. Think about spoiling them for the future. Give them an opportunity to do what they want to do, and that is to have a passion to explore the education that they need.
All right. Thanks, David, so much for being here. David Garcia with The Hartford. We appreciate you joining us today. And we'll be right back with much more information. Stay with us.
We find all kinds of items, and that becomes unclaimed property, and it mounts into millions of dollars. It could be stock, it could be CDs, but it could also be a diamond ring or a gold watch of your dad's. We returned over $50 million to the people of West Virginia. I'm proud of that. You can go on our website, you can look at the names and see if your name's on there or someone that you recognize. We set the standards in a nation in returning unclaimed property.
Treasurer Perdue's office is dedicated to educating the people of West Virginia about financial matters at all stages of life. Students at Willing Park High School recently had a chance to live life in the real world, at least when it comes to a daily budget. Here's more.
You're going to learn about the facts of life here today. You're going to learn what your moms and dads are experiencing every day.
The Get a Life game was created to educate young people about the challenges they will face once they're out of school. Students playing the game are given a fictional budget and a set of bills to pay, just as they would encounter in real life.
That car payment, that house payment, utility payments, and all kinds of other payments that you realize happens, but you don't realize how hard it is sometimes to keep your head above water.
Local businesses come into the schools to help with the Get a Life game. Students visit with each business to learn what services they offer or products they sell. Then they have to decide what they can afford to buy without going over their budget.
They have taken time out of their busy, busy schedule as business leaders all over the Ohio Valley here to help work with you and help you understand what money's all about.
That's our show. Keeping you informed on the Library Television Network, I'm Gina Joins with the Office of West Virginia State Treasurer John Perdue.